Falcons, welcome to this terrific Thursday. We hope you're having a great start to the day. It is Thursday, April 15th. I think they call that tax day, 2021. We're excited you could join us. We got a great show for you today. Let me get it started. All right, so here we go. We've been talking about staying safe. I took the words off the screen yesterday. I want to see if you remembered what they were. And so it's set up that same way today. But hopefully you guys realize those three things we're doing on campus to make sure we can stay as safe in a pandemic as possible. For our friends at home online, again, this is all about accountability and making sure that we are doing three particular behaviors that are going to make your learning that much more successful. That's right, sign in on time, stay on camera, and finish your work. I've got a new slide today. We haven't been doing this year, but this is something we've always done in the past, and we want to welcome our guest teachers. And so we have a few new friends coming to us today. We got Miss Michelle and Mrs. Saylor. These are two friends of mine from the past. They both worked in Kyrene a long time ago. In fact, what's that? Oh, my producers are telling me we have a picture of Miss Michelle and me. We worked together back, I think it was in 2008. It was a long time ago. I might have even had hair, for goodness sakes. Oh, there she is. That's right. She was actually my principal when I was learning to become a principal. So I am super excited to have her on campus. Again, welcome to Miss Michelle and Miss Saylor. Today for lunch, again, no pictures here, but the words here, just have to visualize what is going to be on that plate in front of you. We have Cat in the Hat strawberry yogurt parfait. So my guess is it's going to be some yogurt and there's going to be some strawberries in it. Sound like a plan? If that's not your thing, we got scrambled eggs, bacon, and toast. So another kind of brunch for lunch theme as we did yesterday with that tater tot casserole. Tomorrow, many chocolate covered donuts. I hope you like them. I'm not sure if you do or not, but you may want to get here a little early because I know that is a popular day. Hey, we've been talking about sore behavior on the playground. Yesterday, we highlighted respect. Today, I wanted to highlight organization. And organization can, again, look lots of different ways. But what does it look like when things are organized out there? It looks like people are taking turns, because an organized game means that everyone has participation ability. And that kind of goes along with that idea of equal teams. You know, if you have one team that has two kids on it, one team that has seven, and people don't want that, then that's a problem. We got to get organized and figure out how to get those teams a little bit more even. Now, there are times when a smaller group of kids wants to play a group of more kids. And that's fine if you guys want to do that. But if we're truly looking at making things as fair and as equivalent as possible, we do want to make sure that we have some structure to that. Sometimes identifying some captains or people who pick the teams and then rotate who does that on a daily basis so it's not always the same kid. What it doesn't look like is the same kids get to do everything. I see this with kickball a lot where, you know, a person who might be a better kicker always cuts to the front of the line. That's not okay. That's not organization. And honestly, that's not respect. And so we want to make sure that everyone's getting that opportunity. And I bring this up because I have a group of kids who highlighted to me the other day what organization can look like. And it was an amazing thing to watch. Maybe this is your class, so listen up. This is a group they went out there and they said, well, let's play a soccer game. Well, how are we going to do that? And they troubleshooted all this. I was out on the field. They did not once ask me for help. They figured it out on their own. They created some equal teams and they had a blast. And so they were so organized. I wanted to highlight them. These are a group of 6 and 7-year-olds. They're first graders in Miss Butcher's class. And I thought they did an amazing job showing what organization can do and how that can lead to more happiness on the playground. So awesome job, Miss Butcher's class. Really appreciate the example you are setting out there. Tomorrow, we got a Spirit Sister show. I don't know if you recognize these Spirit Sisters. They look a little younger than maybe they do now, although they are still very young, much younger than me. But our Spirit Sister show is tomorrow. We got Miss Levin and Miss Pincus who are going to be taking us down some amazing paths. Maybe they're going to see you in those mystery goggles. You're going to have to check it out. Also, yesterday, we had And we had to figure out where Mr. Clamp was. And I took a snapshot here to, you know, if you weren't sure where he was, but he was in Miss M's room. And so we are going to get a winner for that tomorrow. I do have a list of teachers who've already put in their guesses for Miss M. So I've already got them on here. They're all right here. And then we are going to do a drawing for that tomorrow to see who wins the prizes. That is all our announcements for today. I appreciate you joining us. We hope you have that amazing Thursday, that you soar high, that you're mighty, that you do whatever it is that makes you successful. Have a great day. Take care, guys.
Good morning, Falcons. It's Mr. B with your Pledge of Allegiance. Go ahead and please stand up. Take your right hand, place it over your heart. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay, please remain standing for a moment of silence. Great job. Now we're going to turn it over to Flash for our Millennial Pledge.
Hi, my name's Grayson.
Hi, my name's Keegan.
And this is Flash. Let's get started on the Millennial Pledge. I pledge to be a Millennial Falcon. Watch me soar.
Safe, organized, accountable, and respectful.
Are my main four. Have a great day, Millennial!
Bye, Millennial!